I just wanted to show you the button that I just hit to get it to go to manual mode. We heard we saw the motors lift up. Now it's ready for manual mode. I can baste, I can do free motion, whatever I want to do. The IQ is going to move freely, the machine's going to move freely. And when I'm ready to go back into IQ mode, I just click finished. And now IQ is ready to work. So let's say I've got my quilt loaded, I'm ready to put double bubble on. So I go design sew quilt, I'm going to edit sew existing. I'm going to go down here, I keep a file called panto layouts, and I'm going to go up here to my double bubble panto layout, continue, it's loaded. I'm going to do a design alignment, which just means I'm going to pick out a point on the screen. I'm going to pick out the top, the very center of the top edge of the quilt, and I'm going to say, okay, IQ, remember where that is. Now I'm going to move you over to that spot and tell you where you are on the quilt. And I've moved to the dead center of my table, just above my quilt edge. And now I'm going to do OK. And now IQ knows exactly where it is on the frame. I'm going to do sew quilt. Again, I'm going to select the rows that I want in the order. Oops, in the order that I want. And I'm going to get my clip mark out. I'm going to move that to the side because I'm just interested in these clip lines. Move the clip line over here. Move the needle just outside the quilt surface. Snap to needle. It adjusts. Now I'm going to pick up this clip line on this side. I'm going to move my head over to this side of the quilt top, just off the edge, and snap to needle, gets rid of that, now it's ready to go. Okay, I'm gonna start this now so you can see it stitch out. You can see, really cool thing about this is it will tell me how many minutes I have left to stitch this out. So it says it'll take about 37 minutes. Now that doesn't include the time it's gonna take me to advance the quilt, so it will be more than that because I have to physically advance the quilt each time. But just the pure IQ quilting time for this particular panto and this particular size quilt is about 37 minutes. So the remaining length I have is 82 yards of thread left to go. Now that's just the top, so we'd have to multiply that by 2 to take into accord the bobbin thread I'm going to go through. So I'm going to click start. And you can see the crosshairs on IQ tell me exactly where it is in the pattern because IQ knows exactly where it is on the quilt. And I can get those beautiful, perfect round circles that look so awesome on real geometric quilt tops very easily. I'm going to cut the thread so that you can see what happens when the thread breaks or the bobbin runs out. Okay, we know that if the bobbin runs out, the top thread stops working. So I'm going to cut the top thread and we'll say we've either got a top thread that has broken or our bobbin thread has run out. And that's how quickly it happens. Okay, I've rethreaded and I'm ready to restart. So I need to move my machine head over to where it stopped. And it stopped about right there. You'll notice I'm using my laser light in a different way. I've got a new bracket down here that allows me to point my laser light right into the center of my hopping foot so I can see exactly where that needle's gonna hit. I'm not sure if you can see it because it's a red laser light on a red fabric. I can certainly see it from where I'm at. So I'm telling the needle that that's where I want it to start. The needle then, IQ knows exactly where that is on the quilt. Again, I'm gonna show you. There's no jog left, right, up half inch, back quarter inch, over eighth of an inch. I just move the machine to where I want it to start. It knows where that is. And now I'm going to hit OK. It takes a single stitch so I can pull up that bobbin thread. All right, so I'm going to take some tacking stitches right there where I want it to start. And then I just hit start. It's going to put that second circle on the inside. And keep right on trucking.